Tyler McGuire was unsuccessful in his attempt against Sebastian Catterstar. How they would both like to be back on top of this division for a crack at the current world champion, Cameron Abasov. Nice knee to the midsection early on from McGuire. Can he affect the takedown here? Agilan stays vertical.
This is very interesting, this first clinch situation that happens here. Both these guys are known as takedown specialists, so this is really gonna tell us a lot how this is gonna play out. I do like the boxing that Thani has showcased. In his matchup against Akiyama, we got to see Thani really put together some high-level boxing. So I'll be interested to see how this plays out if this thing does stay on the feet.
Knees there from Agilan Thani.
Oh, nice little takedown there. You could see once Tyler McGuire was able to lock up those hands, he was able to get the takedown. But Thani's good at this guillotine, but you can see how Tyler McGuire immediately jumps over to the side of the legs there. Now he's in side control. Thani's got to let go of this and start pushing away and work his way back up. Hard to finish from this position, but Thani's got a good squeeze though.
Agilan Thani trying to finish. 110 gone in the first round, set for three. Side control for McGuire, but not in control at the moment. Throws a knee up to the side of the head there.
Nice little knee, though. That knee made Thani release the grip and give Tyler better control here. Now Tyler's inside control, but you can see Tani's trying to take his left leg and circ and squeeze it in. But Tyler looks like he's trying to triangle the legs and work his way up. Oh, good job by Thani to get back up to his feet, though.
McGuire out of that predicament on the ground. Chance of the elbows here, perhaps. Maybe more knees. Look to drop down and change levels to Tyler McGuire.
But Thani was able to utilize those underhooks to keep Tyler from dropping down. That's good wrestling, and Tani's so strong. He turns Tyler McGuire around, presses him up against that wall. Drops down. He gets the legs now. Let's see what Thani can do with it.
Agilan threads a hook, eats a right hand from Tyler, back to center circle here, under 3 minutes remaining in the first. High kick up ends Tyler McGuire. Agilan Thani couldn't capitalize. Intriguing contest so far in a welterweight battle. Overhand right was telegraphed by Tyler McGuire, looking for a takedown, couldn't enact it. Back to their feet now.
Man,
now gets Agilan Thani on his back again, side control for the American.
McGuire is strong in that clinch position. To handle Thani like that, that's saying something. Just how physically strong McGuire is.
Mitch, you've mentioned the strength of both men. Who has the upper hand in the strength? Who do you give it to?
Man, just by these clinch situations, the way that McGuire is able just to kind of out-muscle Thani, that's saying a lot. Ladies and gentlemen, these clinch situations are extremely draining. They just take so much energy away from you that, you know, this is going to be interesting to see how this match progresses because of these clinch situations. You can see Thani going to the body lock here just to keep Tyler's tight.
Half guard position, looking to posture up and land some hands, maybe drop some elbows to the jaw or to the brow of the Malaysian. Good popping right hand, body, then head goes Tyler McGuire, staying busy in this half guard position. 90 seconds remains, first of three. Back and forth contest it's been so far. Thani, who began with one on his pro debut as a 19-year-old, has spent his entire professional career at the very top in one championship.
Oh, beautiful jump over, just floated over to land in side control on Thani. Tyler McGuire is high level, ladies and gentlemen. His grappling is really putting together nicely. You can see that the U.S. Air Force is one of his sponsors. So that's actually really interesting because he's an active military member and he actually gets to train at the U.S. Air Force facility. So this guy has the availability to some of the finest facilities in all the United States.
Uppercuts on the inside there from Agilan Thani. Drives McGuire back against the wall here. Takedown from Agilan Thani. Top position mounts him. He mounts Tyler McGuire.
That was beautifully done, how he was able to step over into mount like that off of the takedown. He's going to give up his back. Thani loves this position. Thani is a neck hunter, but he's got 20 seconds to wrap this thing up real quick.
Let's go up to finish.
What a turn of tide for the Malaysian, Agilan Thani. This inspiring story. But I think time's against him. He won't be able to tap out Tyler McGuire.
10 seconds.
With 10 seconds remaining in the round. But a seesawing, swinging of the pendulum battle between these two fine welterweights.
stop.
We go to the towels. Oh, Dragon, what a ripper.
That was a very important way for Thani to end that round. After being controlled a little bit in the middle chunk of that round, Thani was able to score a beautiful takedown, get on top, get the mount position, and then take the back. Let's take a look at some of these takedowns that happened over the course of this round, just constantly going after each other. Look at McGuire locking up the hands, putting Thani onto his back. This is where he was jumping over. I like this little floatovers that he's doing from the half guard into side control. Here was the second takedown landed by Tyler as he was able to sit there into half guard. And then Thani getting some payback here as he reaps the leg, ends up, steps over into mount. Beautiful grappling display by these two studs.
We are ready to roll. Second round set for three. Don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms at ONE Championship. Check us out on Facebook and Twitter.
Let's go.
Second of three in this welterweight contest.
This is what I want to see. Thani says this is where he was going to really start utilizing his boxing, and that's what I want to see from him. But Tyler is not giving him any space. Immediately closes the distance, doesn't want to bang with Thani, and presses him right up against that circle wall. Beautiful spin around takedown to end up on the back.
What can Tyler McGuire do with the back of the Malaysian early in the round? Thani stands. Has him wrapped on like a backpack now.
Beautiful.
Spills over the top, and a little gap-munching knee there from Agilan Thani just to say hello. Backs Thani up against the fence.
Good job by McGuire to work his way back from the back position, how he ended round one, to start the position there. But Thani did a beautiful job of getting him off, and now we're right back into that clinch. Look at the way McGuire's driving his head up into the chin. That's going to enable him to get a little bit better control on the posture of Thani and kind of dictate where Tani's able to go.
Overhook of the
action red
left arm of Tyler McGuire. Referee Muhammad Suleiman saying he wants to see plenty of action. McGuire getting the wrist control, letting go of that left wrist of Thani now. Thani trying to get an underhook there. Dragon off the left arm.
You can see they're doing a little bit of hand fight there at the bottom on the side that's far from us. And you can see how Tyler's trying to get that body lock. And once he's able to get that body lock, he has such good control. Every time McGuire is able to lock his hands, he is able to take Thani down. So Thani needs to fight those hands a little bit more, dig underhooks, and try to pry McGuire up so they're chest to chest rather than McGuire dropping down and attacking those legs and locking those hands around his body.
Let's go to finish.
Look at that, just driving the forearm into the throat of Thani, making it uncomfortable. Beautiful step over. Thani tried to scramble out of it. Good sprawl there.
Back onto their feet. Under 3 minutes remaining. Second of three. Short right hand from Agilan Thani. McGuire thought about a jumping knee. Looking to breathe a little heavy now. Tyler McGuire. Southpaw stance on the American. So too Thani. It's been very humid the last few days here in Singapore with all the afternoon rain we've been having. Good short right hand and a drift away there from Thani. McGuire has been dominant in the takedown so far, as expected. What can he do on the feet here? Eats a right hand from Thani.
You can see when every time Tyler enters that pocket, Thani is touching him with that right hand. All these high energy exertion grappling exchanges are really going to take effect as we get into the deep water here. But Thani's starting to touch him up with these hands. Tyler's got to shoot him for a takedown here.
Circles off counterclockwise, now drifts clockwise as Tyler McGuire trying to switch up the angles on Agilan. Agilan controlling center circle. Goes for a head kick to Agilan. We will see Agilan pull out some techniques you wouldn't think of every now and then. Head kicks among them, some spinning back fists too. Likes the knees on the inside. Body shots here, but no real starch behind them from Tyler McGuire. And they press up against the wall with 80 seconds on the clock.
Yeah, you can see the way, you know, McGuire kind of strikes. He was kind of looking for that opening just so he could get inside the hands of Thani and get in, to that clinch. That's really where he does his best work. He's going to try to lock his hands, but this is what I was talking about, how Thani is able to dig those underhooks and pry McGuire up. But the minute McGuire locks those hands, really from anywhere, he doesn't have to be around the hips, he can be around the body, he just twists and torques you down because he is so strong.
Let's go, what to finish, guys.
Instructions coming from the corner of Tyler McGuire. Meanwhile, referee Mohamed Suleiman urging both combatants to stay busy as Tyler takes the back of Agilan.
Good job to just kind of sit Thani down. This is going to enable him to get a little bit of rest, kind of stop the scrambling that's been happening where Thani is just constantly moving. Now he's going to try to get one hook in, not see if he can get the other hook in before Thani turns into him. Uh-oh, that arm's under the neck. Tyler's got a good squeeze.
10 seconds remaining. Defense. Look at that. Picked it off easily. Puts him inside the full guard. Nicely done from the Malaysian Agilan Thani. Closes down Tyler McGuire. Two rounds in, one to go. Okay, Mitch, how about we take a look at both men and how's the fuel tank reading right now?
You know, I thought that maybe we would see some just kind of fatigue on Tyler McGuire, but when he is tired, this goes to show you just how intellectual he is. The minute he started to fatigue, he immediately found his way into the clinch where he was able to rest and utilize some of that high-level grappling. Here, it'll be very important for Tyler McGuire to get that clinch, get that body lock, and get back down to the ground. Thani needs to keep his distance. He needs to utilize that big, massive head kick that he threw inside that second round, but then also just keep the distance, keep moving.
If you were trying to judge fatigue on the vision there, maybe you'd say that McGuire was breathing slightly the heavier, but both men still look like they have plenty in them for the third and final round of this welterweight contest between two former world title challengers.
Nice little opening leg kick there from Thani. See, this is what Tyler wants. He wants to get in tight. He wants to avoid the hands, but a beautiful trip there from Thani.
Came close with a high knee too, did Agilan. Stiff right hand, nicely done from Tyler McGuire. That's more like it from the American. Shoots in low for a double leg. To no avail though, Agilan threads the high knee, turning left hand, didn't have the starch behind it. Can hear Tyler McGuire's corner saying, beautiful work, Tyler. Encouraging. Slings the high leg kick there, does Agilan Thani.
That was a good start to that third round. Both these guys really started to put it on. Tyler showcasing some better striking that he has in the second and first round. I'd like to see him keep that pressure on, keep his hands up a little bit tighter. But Tani's got to let those hands go. Nice little uppercut on the entry.
Thani does have 5 submissions, 3 knockouts in his career. 6 submissions and 2 knockouts for Tyler McGuire. The Malaysian overhooking that left arm of the American. Wrist control also from Agilan Thani. It is still anyone's for the taking, you feel, with 3:40 remaining in the contest. Don't forget, folks, our 3 judges circle side are scoring as an overall contest, not round by round.
See, that's what Tyler wants. Tyler wants to lock his hands, so it's really important that Thani does whatever he can to avoid McGuire from locking his hands together. That underhook is extremely important. Watch Thani keep trying to dig his arms underneath the arms of McGuire just so he has control, because once McGuire gets those hands locked, it's really difficult to stop that takedown.
Just a little wardrobe malfunction there for Agilan Thani. Gonna tie those trunks up.
Ready? Let's go.
Mitch, if you're in the corner of the Malaysian Agilan, what are you telling him to do in the remaining moments of this contest?
I'd like to see him utilize that jab and really start to put some pressure on McGuire with those hands. He's been landing with the right hand, but Tyler McGuire did a beautiful job of ducking under that one and then trying to answer right back. I think the scorecards might be a little bit in the favor of McGuire, but you never know, because Thani can turn the tide at a moment's notice. But this is what he has to avoid. He has to avoid this grind coming from McGuire.
Thani would love to get a shot again at Cameron Abasov. Abasov, who beat Thani back in December 2018. Beat him by the way that Tyler McGuire is now trying to rear naked choke. Can he slap it on here with 2:15 remaining?
Thani's got good defense here, but you can just see the power of McGuire. Now he's going to start looking for the chokes. You can see how he has one arm underneath, and that's just going to give him control. Now he has two arms underneath, and one arm just came over, and now he's starting to look for the choke. Thani's got to fight that hand.
This could be trouble for Agilan Thani.
As long as one arm is underneath the arm of Thani, it's going to give him space. But watch McGuire try to take his left arm and pull it out from underneath Thani's arm, and then he'll be able to get that choke. But right now, you can see Thani trying to put his back on the mat. That's a good strategy by Thani to avoid the choke.
McGuire's going to try and flatten him out. There he goes. 1:30 remains now. It's survival mode for Agilan Thani.
Oh, look at that. He used his other arm to pry the arm off, but Thani smart, goes flat to his back. McGuire's going to try to handcuff that arm behind him. Look at that. Now he can open up for some ground and pound. He's got 1 minute to try to finish here. Thani's going to be tough to finish, though. Thani's got really good defense. But look at this. See how he has his arm trapped? So he has his right arm around the arm of Thani's, and it's coming around his neck. Beautiful job by Thani to escape that. But McGuire's just not giving him any room. Look at that. Now his arm's coming back under the neck. It's going to be so tough because they're also really slippery. So it's going to be really hard to get a good hold on somebody.
There was some very good back and forth in the opening two rounds, but it's been mostly dominance from Tyler McGuire here in the third. Somehow Thani's going to find a way to turn the tide. As Tyler takes his back, it looks to flatten him out. 25 seconds to go now. The American in complete control. You can sign the pink slips. You can sign the ownership papers. Can Tyler tap out Thani in the final stages? Agilan surviving. It looks like we'll go down to the judges here in Singapore for this one.
10 seconds left.
Final attempt at a sub from Tyler McGuire. Thani survives yet again. Another escape from the Malaysian. And we are going to our three judges.
Wow, what a performance by Tyler McGuire. He was just all over Thani right from jump. As soon as that opening bell round, Tyler McGuire started to put it on Thani. Just constant. What a high-level matchup. Lots of grappling going on in this one. Lots of the clinch. And you would think Tyler would fatigue, but man, that boy is conditioned. Just ragdolling Thani. And you've seen Thani in the past do this to countless opponents. And to have it done to himself really says a lot about the grappling ability of Tyler McGuire.
How do you score it, folks? Wherever you're watching around the world, we hope you're enjoying ONE Championship Big Bang 2 from Singapore Indoor Stadium. Make sure to follow us across all your social media platforms at ONE Championship on Instagram and, of course, on TikTok. Let's go to Tom Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the Blue Corner, Tyler McGuire!
A dominant third round seals the deal for the American Tyler McGuire.